Hello everyone, this is Zen, Blitz, and guys. Today we're reading Isaiah 9 from the NRS version, also known as the NIV version. If you guys want to be long, you guys can go to the class at BibleGT.com, or you guys can go to Baba. I don't care how you want to end up, but let's get started. Isaiah 9, NRS version, and NIV version. Nevertheless, there will be no more gloom for those who are in distress. In the past, he humbled the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali, but in the future, he will honor Galilee of the nations by the way of the sea beyond the Jordan. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of dead darkness, a deep darkness, a light has dawned. You have enlarged the nation and increased their joy. They rejoice before you. As people rejoice at the harvest, as warriors rejoice when dividing the plunder. For as in the day of Midian's death, you have shattered the yoke that burdens them, the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor. Every warrior's boot used in battle and every garment rolled in blood will be destined for burning, will be fuel for the fire, for us. For to us a child is born, for to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government, peace shall be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it of justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. The Lord's anger against Israel. The Lord has sent a message against Jacob, it will fall on Israel. All the people know it. Ephraim and the inhabitants of Samaria, who say of pride and arrogance of heart, the bricks have fallen down, but we will rebuild with dressed stone. The fig trees have been felled, but we will replace them with cedars. The Lord has strengthened Rezin's foes against them, and has spread their enemies on Arameans from the east and Philistines from the west. Has devoured Israel with open mouth. Yet for all this, his anger is not turned away, his hand is still upraised. But the people have not returned to instruct them, nor have they sought the Lord Almighty. So the Lord will cut off from Israel both head and tail, both palm branch and reed in a single day. The elders and dignitaries are the head. The prophets who teach lies are the tail. So yes, those who guide this people mislead them, and those who are guided are led astray. Therefore the Lord will take no pleasure in the young men, nor will he pity the fatherless and widows, for everyone is ungodly and wicked. Every mouth speaks folly. Yet for all this, his anger is not turned away, his hand is still upraised. Surely wickedness burns like a fire. It consumes briars and thorns. It sets the forest thickets ablaze so that it rolls upward in a column of smoke. By the wrath of the Lord Almighty, the land will be scorched, and the people will be fuel for the fire. They'll not spare one another. On the right, they'll devour, but still be hungry. On the left, they'll eat and not be but not be satisfied. Each will feed on the flesh of their own offspring. Manasseh will feed on Ephraim, and Ephraim on Manasseh. Together they will turn against Judah, yet for all of this his anger is not turned away. His hand is still upraised. Okay guys, enjoy it. I'll see you next time. Bye.